Avoid emotional decision making when falling in love with a home. That's what we're talking about today. Every homebuyer hopes to find the perfect house. The one that as soon as you walk through the front door, you know it's the one for you. It happens, and when it does, I'm so happy for my buyers. I always want my buyers to fall in love with their perfect house and live happily ever after. But just like in relationships, however, emotions often come into play during the home buying journey. Emotions that may result in some not so loving feelings. While I'm not a therapist, I can talk you through your emotions about the homes we visit and help you identify if you're making decisions when you're with your heart and not your head. There are 6 basic emotions, so let's look at how they can affect your decision-making skills. The first one is fear. We have all learned that fear triggers the fight or flight response. In terms of making decisions, fear may cause you to flee from making a decision at all, which could make your home buying experience exhausting. And if you're afraid that you'll run out of time or that you pass on a house and you won't find another one, you may fight by making a rash decision too quickly. Number 2, sadness. Feeling sad can cause you to lower your expectations and you may settle for less than what you truly want. You may decide that you don't need a certain features that you previously wanted. You may settle for one of the first homes you see instead of persevering with your search. Number 3, disgust. Disgust can cause you to eliminate choices that may otherwise have been in the running. You might find the perfect floor plan, style, or location, but the home has a bad odor or filthy floor or some other off-putting defect, you might not be able to look past it or stomach it, even if it's a completely reversible problem. 4, surprise. Surprise is an emotion that is fleeting and it happens quickly and then subsides. Surprises can be pleasant, like if you go see a home and you were not expecting it to be great and find it's much nicer than you expected. But if you're out touring the home and has a rat runs out of the pantry, for example, you would get a negative surprise. While surprises don't last, the memory does, and it can influence how you feel about the event and the house. Number 5, happiness. We all want to feel happy when buying a home, but be careful that your excitement doesn't cause you to make bad decisions. When you're happy or excited, you tend to underestimate risks and assume everything will work out. People also tend to spend more money than they planned when they're super excited about a property. Number 6, anger. Anger can also cause you to take bigger risks. Research shows that angry people are more likely to make impulsive decisions. Anger can sometimes be helpful. If handled properly, anger can help you identify your needs and outline the action steps that are needed to get the information you need to act responsibly. As you can see, buying a house is definitely an emotional experience, so you need an agent on your side that can help guide you in a non-emotional way, in a very emotional journey. I'm Julie Patterson, broker owner of Gateway Properties, and we're a boutique brokerage right here in Placer County. My team and I, we live here, we work here, and we love it here. We want you to love where you live too. See you soon.